Welcome back to the Lackluster Channel. In March of 2023, I published a story about an incident that occurred the year prior, where a viewer named John was protesting speed traps set by Troop 9 of the Delaware State Police.
I am engaged in a First Amendment activity that
sir,
is protected
by... take the sign if
you
put
are
it
not, listen, you are not
you
taking
sign,
my property.
Listen to me, if you put it...
You are not taking
not
my property. What's your badge number?
My badge number's right there.
At first, we only had John's cell phone footage, which showed one of the most egregious incidents I've covered to date.
Because you
disorderly
had your,
conduct.
Because you had your finger
disorderly
out.
Conduct
now,
what?
Here's what's about to happen. You're about to be arrested again for resisting arrest. Huh?
The video shows Trooper Nicholas Gallo and Corporal Stephen Douglas harassing John for holding a sign that reads, "Radar ahead."
Do people to come up here? I got a man trying to steal my property, telling me he's not going to let me do something that's constitutionally protected. No, I'm not. What's the statute for that? What's the statute? I have armed men coming up threatening to steal my property. You're not taking sh-
The trooper shut down John's protest, violating his rights to free speech, peaceful assembly, and protesting.
You have nothing. You're not going
to
not allow me because you have no authority to stop me. Period. No authority to stop me.
I'm not going to let you do it, sir.
You have no authority to stop me.
You wanted our attention. You got it.
I don't want your attention. Go the fuck away, road pirate.
Our attention.
Go away, road pirates!
The troopers smile from ear to ear as they assault him and force him to cease protesting after they steal and destroy his sign.
Put your hands on him. You see what this motherfucker did? You see what he did? Don't put your hands on me. Do not put. Give me my property back, you piece of. Give me my property back. You see this? You tyrant piece of sh**!
John then called 911 to seek help from dispatch.
Hey, you guys, that's Sebo. For that guy.
Yes, we are.
He just called up here. He said you stole a sign, they ripped it up. And he doesn't have to tell us anything, so I told him to call through that.
After the troopers assaulted John, stole, and destroyed his property, they stay on scene and wait until he leaves. John drove up to the next light, made a legal U-turn, and as he passed the officers who had just violated him, he flips them off. And the troopers immediately pull out to chase him down. Dashcam footage shows the officers responding to the unlawful traffic stop, traveling well above the 55-mile-per-hour speed limit. Corporal Douglas's cruiser is seen putting the lives of citizens at grave risk by traveling 104 miles per hour. Another trooper is shown doing more than 90, all to retaliate against a man for the content of his speech. Worse is that before arriving, the troopers conspired against John, communicating over the radio about what false charges they could hit him with, fully aware that it would serve to do nothing but waste John's time and perhaps cost him money to fight.
We can lock him up for disorderly conduct. It may not go anywhere, but we can definitely lock him up for disorderly conduct.
The reason I stopped you is you had your hand out the window with
so what?
The finger.
So what? It's constitutionally protected speech.
Is the reason why you're doing it? Is the reason why you're doing that?
You're stopping me for constitutionally protected speech, right?
Because you had your hand out the window.
I know you're being detained.
For
okay?
What?
You're being detained.
I told you why I stopped you already, sir.
For putting my middle finger up. That's
yes.
Correct?
No,
correct.
No, exactly. Right.
You extended correct. Your arm out the window.
No, I had my middle finger out the window.
Okay, let me get your ID.
John was maliciously charged with a violation for failure to give a right-hand turn signal. After John is set free, the troopers fantasize of their future plans of locking John up, taking his son and his dog.
Now we're gonna have problems with that guy.
Oh yeah.
But after a while, he's gonna do something stupid.
Mm-hmm.
He's gonna do something stupid.
He got his kid in the car.
And then,
you know what I mean? Dog in the car. Lock him up.
Mm-hmm. Put his dog in the impound. Mm-hmm. You know, but he'll do something stupid. But for now, it is what it is.
Corporal Box then calls his supervisor, admitting on the call that they had all been advised that they weren't allowed to take anyone's signs.
You know, the guy's F you. I could do what I want. This, that, and the other. Now he's like, you know, with the sign. Now Gallo took the guy's sign. And I was like, I remember back when we used to have all the beggars on Troop 2, and we would take the signs, and they told us we can't take the signs. Well, Gallo took guy's sign and ripped it up. So now he's pissed about that.
He also admits to being aware that flipping someone off is not a valid reason for a traffic stop.
Gave the finger as he was driving away. Dougie pulled him over and then wrote him for hand gestures. So wrote him a citation for hand gestures. So
I lost you for a second. He pulled him over and wrote him for what?
A hand gesture. Like the hand gesture. I said, that's pushing it.
He pulled him over for it, like giving him the middle finger.
Giving him middle finger. So,
yeah, you can't do that.
Yeah.
That'll get dropped.
Yeah, it's going to get thrown. I told him that's going to get thrown out. But it's just going, it's going to cause the problem. I was going to give him back the sign, but Gallo already ripped the sign up. So, because I went and talked to him, and obviously he didn't want to hear anything I had to say by that time, But, just giving you a heads up. He already called the troops, so he's going to go a little, obviously he's going to go a little further, so you or Burnett or Captain are going to hear something.
Trooper Box continues to say that he was aware that the citation was not a proper charge for the lawful act that John had performed.
Apparently, while we were sitting there, the guy gives the finger, that's what Dougie said, so Dougie went and pulled him over and started writing him up. I said, that's not really going to fly, but
The supervisor advised Corporal Box that they'd have to look for something stupid to lock him up for in the future.
He's looking for confrontation.
Yes, he is. My problem is, he's doing this, and he has a kid and a dog in the car, he's gonna mess up eventually. He's going to do something really stupid, and then we are going to be able to really lock him up.
Yeah, we need to look at something more that applies, like maybe something stupid, park in the roadway.
Right.
Yeah, something like that that'll apply. Unfortunately, we can't pull people over. We can't write a ticket for telling them to fuck off or giving us the middle finger or stuff like that. That's their right to do so.
Yeah.
Remember, this call was made specifically to head off a possible incoming complaint, for what both officers know was a clear injustice and a violation of their sworn oaths. But the supervisor doesn't sound concerned with getting his troops right, and instead of investigating their actions, he says he'll investigate John.
Alright, I'll do some more work up on this guy, and I'll pass it on. I'm sure I haven't got any emails yet that said he called.
Yeah, he called. He called Kurt. Kurt's on the desk, so he did call.
He said he's still inside, they ripped it up. And he doesn't have to tell us anything, so I told him to call through that.
After talking with his supervisor, Trooper Box calls Trooper Gallo to laugh about inconveniencing John with the ticket.
I call Pop. He's like, we shouldn't have ripped the sign up, And then number two, we have no real basis to write him. It's going to get thrown out anyway, it's going to get thrown out, the hand gesture thing. Yeah, it's not, uh-huh. It doesn't count for fingers, for fingers, middle fingers, so.
It doesn't count for sticky hand up and doing middle fingers.
Nope.
All right. Well,
I'll police
is inconvenient
him,
so you
got it. Right. So now, he's going to do something stupid one day where we are going to be able to lock him up for disorderly conduct.
Trooper Box finally realizes his microphone is on and cuts it off mid-call. These videos show a level of awe-inspiring police misconduct, with troopers conspiring amongst themselves to violate the rights of a citizen after assaulting him, stealing, and destroying his property. Worse is that it shows that the leadership ranks are rotten to the core, and this clip seems to incriminate the local prosecutors as well.
Improper use of hand signals. Hey, it's all good. Of course, I'll see him in court at some point, I'm going to just make sure police prosecution doesn't drop it.
With videos like this being distributed daily, I ask how anyone could trust their government, or how anyone could have faith in the justice system, especially considering that no one involved has been fired, suspended, or prosecuted. John's lawsuit is currently in the discovery phase, and as it moves forward, I will continue to keep you informed. But before you get your hopes up, know that it's likely that he'll receive a judgment for catching these traitors in the act. But as usual, the taxpayers will once again be the ones held liable and will be forced to pay for the misdeeds of the unelected scum shown in these videos. But hey, look over here, everyone. Aliens in Antarctica and Hunter Biden's new dick pic. This is definitely the age of bread and circuses. Let me know what you think of this incident down below. John does not have a YouTube channel, so if you'd like to leave him a message, leave it in the comment section as well.
I'm going to reach into my pocket and get my license.
You're fine.
And I'm going to take you to court.
But here's what I'm saying. Take it to court. That's what I want you to do.
Thanks for watching. If you have a video, use the submit link in the description or pinned comment. If you enjoyed this one, subscribe and hit the bell for future content. And check out our other channels, Lady Lackluster and The Odd Side. Remember to like, share, and leave a comment about what you think of this interaction. It's the easiest way for you to help expose corruption and misconduct. Merchandise is available using the links below. Join the Lackluster family for just a buck if you'd like to further support the channel. Get a Lack logo next to your name, custom emotes, and early access to videos. I look forward to seeing you in the next one. All links are down below.